In our first story, Allison Fundis shows Fig how she explores and researches the deep ocean in her ship called the Nautilus. I love boat names. I saw one called, this is so good, the Codfather. Okay. How about this one? It's a boat time. Because of the boat, you all are no fun.
Did you know that we have better maps of the surface of the moon than we do of our own oceans? That's so wild. 85% of the Earth remains unexplored, but using cutting-edge technology, scientists are working to understand and protect Earth's last frontier. And today, I'm in San Pedro, California, to meet Allison Fundis, an ocean explorer and chief operating officer of the Nautilus, to find out how she and her team are expanding what we know about the sea.
Every other breath of air that you take, half of that oxygen comes from the ocean. Some of the food that you eat, some of the products that you use comes from the ocean. And we just still don't have a basic fundamental understanding of how our planet works. And the ocean is the driving force for a lot of the systems on our planet, like weather and climate.
Allison has been on over 50 expeditions all over the world, studying everything from oceanography to archaeology.
Each expedition is totally unique. We look at geology, biology, maritime history. We often look at shipwrecks. We've even recently explored for Amelia Earhart's lost airplane.
Wow.
So a lot of different types of expeditions that are just a joy to be a part of.
On the Nautilus, Allison commands a crew of 48 people, including sailors, scientists, engineers, and educators. This vessel features a high-tech control room for piloting remote submersibles, satellite links for instant worldwide communication and live streaming, and even an onboard laboratory. But one of its most important scientific tools is on the bottom of the ship.
We've got a system called a multi-beam sonar. And what that does is it allows us to map the seafloor at a very high detail. It sends a ping of sound down to the seafloor, and then we wait for the return of that ping of sound to come back. And based on the length of time it takes to travel to the seafloor and come back, we know the distance.
Okay.
And so we send multiple pings, and then we can get a picture of what the shape of the seafloor looks like.
After we get those high detail maps, that gives us a much better understanding of where we want to go in and send our ROVs.
Those are remotely operated vehicles.
That's right. The depths that we look at are much too deep for humans to go. So where you and I are standing right now, we're at one atmosphere in terms of pressure. In one atmosphere, for every square inch on our bodies, there is 14.6 pounds of pressure on that square inch.
What that means is, when you get in the water, for every 33 feet you dive, the pressure increases by one atmosphere.
So by the time you get to the depths that our vehicles can go, it's the equivalent of an elephant on every square inch of your body in terms of pressure that's exerted.
To deal with these incredible pressures, Nautilus has an incredible ROV, Hercules. This car-sized submersible has thrusters for precise moments, robotic arms outfitted with pinchers to pick up samples, and what might be the coolest vacuum in the world that sucks up geological and biological samples. Hercules has a suite of instruments and sensors to help study the deep ocean, including a temperature probe to study hydrothermal vents that can get up to 750 degrees Fahrenheit.
We also have a specialized sensor on board Hercules called a CTD, or a conductivity, temperature, and depth sensor. And so that'll measure things like salinity and obviously temperature of where the vehicle is. And then it also measures the pressure, so we know what depth the vehicle is at as well.
With 7 cameras and multiple lights, Hercules allows Allison's team to see the incredible sea creatures and geologic features hiding 12,000 feet below the surface.
Thank you so much, Allison, for teaching me so much about the work that you do, mapping the ocean, how you have Hercules checking biology, chemistry, archaeology, and geology. It's so cool.
It was so great to have you here today, and please do tune in on our next expedition. It would be great to have you join us.